Hello, welcome back. In this segment, I want to introduce propositional logic. I will use the example that are shown here to model the logic from natural language description. Okay, let's first consider the left-hand side. If the train arrives late and there is no taxis at the station, then John is late for his meeting. John is not late for his meeting. The train did arrive late. Therefore, there were taxis at the station. The second example, if it is raining and Jane doesn't have her umbrella with her, then she will get wet. Jane is not wet. It is raining. Therefore, Jane has her umbrella with her. Although these two examples may come across as different at the fine-grained level, right? Under the hood, so to speak. These two examples are essentially the same. If you take the left-hand side example, let's see. Train arriving late is one statement, right? It is raining on the right-hand side is a corresponding statement. No taxis at the station is one statement on the left. On the right-hand side, no umbrella with her, right? Doesn't have her umbrella. Then John is late for his meeting on the left-hand side. Here, then she will get wet. John is not late for his meeting on the left-hand side. Okay, right-hand side, Jane is not wet. Train did arrive late. It's here. It is raining. There's a therefore here, and there's also therefore here. That's a conclusion. There were taxis at the station. That's a conclusion we are arriving here. Jane has her umbrella with her. It's difficult to compare these two examples. They look different. But as soon as we start using symbols, we can see these two examples are actually the same. If I can rewrite these two examples as follows. Some P, we don't really know whether it's train arriving late or it is raining. Doesn't really matter. And some not Q, okay, then some conclusion happens. Then either he's late for this meeting on the left-hand side or she will get right. So let's call it R. Okay. So if P and not Q, then R. That's the first sentence from both examples. And then we are saying not late for his meeting. That's not of the last part, not R. The train did arrive late. That's another statement. Here, it is raining. So they both correspond to P. So we know P happened on both. What is the conclusion we are saying? Therefore, there were taxis at the station. Taxis at the station is nothing but Q. Okay. So then we are saying Q. So if we abstract using symbols like I modeled, P stands for either it could stand for train arriving late or it is raining on the right-hand side. If you look at it like this, using abstract symbols, we can conclude both examples are the same. You can instantiate the left-hand side with P being train arriving late, Q being taxis at the station, R is late for his meeting. John is not late for his meeting. That's the reason I put not R. The train did arrive late. That means P is true. Then we can conclude there were taxis at the station for the left-hand side. Okay. Because logically speaking, if you reason about it, you can derive this conclusion. And we will talk about how we derive logically from P and not Q, then R, and not R happened. That means the conclusion is wrong. That means the premise must be wrong, but a portion of the premise is true. P is true. Therefore, we are saying this has to be false. Therefore, Q has to be true. Okay. Same thing you can apply to the right-hand side and convince yourself these two examples are the same. What is propositional logic? Proposition logic is basically taking your sentences, model them using symbols like what I have done, and then apply logical reasoning to come to conclusions. In the next segment, I will precisely define meaning of and, not, then, so that we all agree on the notation and the semantics of these operators. All right, that's all. Thank you very much for your attention.